Good morning, children. Let us do question number 8 of exercise 1.1. Is 8 by 9 the multiplicative inverse of minus 1, 1 by 8? Why or why not? Now, in this question, children, we have to find whether 8 by 9 is the multiplicative inverse of minus 1, 1 by 8. And as I told you, the product of rational number and its multiplicative inverse is always equal to 1. So we'll check whether the rational number and its multiplicative inverse, their product is coming 1 or not. So if we do 8 by 9 multiplied by minus 1, 1 by 8, right? We have to find the product of rational number and its multiplicative inverse. So 8 by 9 into minus 1, 1 by 8. So change this into improper fraction. Minus 1, 1 by 8 is written as minus 9 by 8. So 8 and 8 cancel, 9 and 9 cancel, we are left with minus 1. But we know that product of rational number and its multiplicative inverse should always be equal to 1. It is not coming equal to 1, it is coming equal to minus 1. So we can say 8 by 9 is not the multiplicative inverse of minus 1, 1 by 8. Now coming to next question, 9th, is 0.3 the multiplicative inverse of 3, 1 by 3, why or why not? Again, for that we have to find the product of 0.3 and 3, 1 by 3. So we have to check whether 0.3 is the multiplicative of this number. So again, convert it into improper fraction. 3 3 is a 9 plus 1, 10 by 3. And 0.3 is written as 3 by 10. When we remove this decimal, we get 1 0 in the denominator, that is 10. So 3 by 10 into 10 by 3. On dividing, 10, 10 cancels, 3, 3 cancels, we are left with 1. So we can say as the product of rational number and its multiplicative inverse is equal to 1. So we can say yes, 0.3 is the multiplicative inverse of 3, 1 by 3. Now coming to 10th question, the rational number that does not have a reciprocal. So you can see 0 is the rational number, because if we do its reciprocal, 0 is written as 0 by 1 and its reciprocal is 1 by 0, and 1 by 0 is not defined. So 0 is the only rational number which have no reciprocal. Second part is the rational number that are equal to their reciprocals. The numbers which are equal to their reciprocals are 1 and minus 1, because 1 is written as 1 by 1 and its reciprocal is also 1 by 1, that is equal to 1. And reciprocal of minus 1 by 1 is minus 1 by 1 only, that is equal to minus 1. So 1 and minus 1 have their own reciprocals. Then rational number that is equal to its negative, 0. Because we know 0 is a neutral integer, it has not neither negative nor positive. So negative of 0 is always 0 only. We cannot write minus 0. So the number which is equal to its negative is 0. Now coming to fill-ups, 0 has dash reciprocal, 0 has no reciprocal. As I told you, 0, we cannot do the reciprocal of 0 because that is equal to not defined. So 0 has no reciprocal. Number dash and dash are their own reciprocals. As I explained you here, 1 and minus 1 are their own reciprocals. Reciprocal of minus 5 is, so to do its reciprocal, put 1 in the denominator. Now interchange numerator and denominator to get the reciprocal. We get minus 1 by 5 is the reciprocal of minus 5. Reciprocal of 1 by x, where x cannot be 0, x should not be 0, right? If x 0, then it becomes not defined form. So reciprocal of 1 by x is x only. The product of two rational number is always a rational number. As I have told you, in properties of rational number, a into b always gives c. A into B means if we find the product of two rational number, we always get a rational number. So that is why product of two rational number is always a rational number. Then the reciprocal of positive rational number is dash. The reciprocal of positive rational number is positive. For example, 3 is a positive number and its reciprocal is 1 by 3, which is also positive. 3 is positive, reciprocal is 1 by 3. This is also positive. So the reciprocal of positive rational number is always positive. So this completes your exercise 1.1. Thank you so much.